Base44 just sold for $80 million to Wix. And in this video, we're going to do a first impressions walkthrough of Base44, showing you what it's capable of, what are the unique features that sets it apart from Bolt and Lovable. You're definitely going to want to check those out because they were a little unexpected for me. And I'm also going to build a real app from start to finish so you can see what it's capable of. Leave a comment below as you're watching to let me know if Base44 is something that you would want to use yourself. Let's jump into it. The homepage looks similar to other AI app builders like Bolt and Lovable. A couple differences. I really like how they have these ideas to get started with. So you can select a category like travel planning, and then there's different app ideas. And if you click on it, it'll put in a pre-written prompt, which I think is pretty cool and helpful for people who are getting started. There's also this styling instructions, which I think is also really helpful for people who aren't technical, don't have a style background, and I really like this. So why don't I go down and add the claymorphism style here? So basically what that does is it just adds this prompt, which is at the top, and then below, you can add the rest of your prompt. So why don't we choose one of these categories? Why don't we go into home management and do a chore scheduler? Okay, one thing I just saw is if you click that, it looks like it got rid of the style. Now, I'm not sure if it's still there, but I'm going to add that. Okay, there. So basically what you want to do is first add the prompt and then add the design afterwards. So let's send this, and I'm going to talk through and give you my honest impressions as it's building, because this is the first time I'm using Base44 myself. So here on the left, it is very similar to what I've seen with other AI app builders so far. I like how it kind of puts things into tasks here and checks them off as it goes. And then on the right side, this is where we're going to be able to preview the app. It looks like they have, similarly to Bolt and Lovable, a discuss mode. So you can, you know, ask it questions and plan before actually having it write code, which is pretty nice. And then there's also settings here. We can change our model, which is nice. So default Claude Sonnet 4 or Gemini 2.5 Pro. Right now it's on default. So just it selects the right model for you. Okay, so it finished the first build out and we can see everything that it did. It kind of, on a line item basis, told us what it created. You can also manage things like users. So in Base44, everything is integrated into the platform. So you don't integrate with a separate database or backend like Supabase, which is what you do with most of the other AI app builders. It is fully integrated into one. And then you can see we have our database fully integrated into Base44. Now, my one question here is, what does it look like if you wanted to go off of Base44 and like use Cursor and own the code? That's the one thing that I'm just curious about, and I'll have to do a little bit more research and something to be aware of. So if it's all integrated, yes, that's easier to get started, but what does that look like in the future? My initial impression is this is kind of a mix between like, you know, it's a mix between Lovable and Bolt and then something like Squarespace almost, which makes sense because Wix, which is a website builder, bought them. So it makes sense that they would be interested in this as more of an all-in-one platform. And so far, it looks like it would be more for the non-technical user who doesn't want to deal with Supabase. Now let's check out the preview here. So it's loading. Here we can see the preview. It used that clay morphism design. And we can go to the different pages. So we have a dashboard, family members, and kind of manage it and everything here. There's a family tab so we can see who's in the family. Looks like we can add a member. So you can choose adult, teen, child, kind of cool. And that added a member under chores. And it looks like it added in kind of this like dummy data by default, but you can see the chores. And then it also built out a calendar for the week. And if I click generate week, says it's going to automatically generate assignments. So let's see. It did. And then you could kind of check off and mark something as complete. And it looks like right now you kind of have access to do all of that yourself. Then here I see there is some settings here to see the files. Looks like there's a beta feature to export the project as a zip file or to GitHub. So It looks like it is adding that integration to GitHub. I'm curious what the database integration looks like, or how do you move your database if you wanted to get off Base44. I'm still not sure it's possible, but it does look like you're able to sync to GitHub. You could also share your app here up on the top. Up here, it looks like we can view our app in mobile. And then we have an activity monitor here as well. So let's go back to desktop. So my first impression is like it is quite good for a first like draft here. I think that it is really good at integrating the backend and having it all in one is pretty cool to see. So the prompt I wrote is I want to add a landing page where users sign up, add onboarding to add family members and chores to their family. So let's send that away. While it's doing it, I noticed there's also a visual edit button, which is nice, something that Lovable has as well to help visually edit. And it looks like if I click that, I can kind of access specific things, and then I should be able to just make changes. This is very similar to Lovable to change the colors or text or things. Let's go back to publish, or let's just go to the app. And let's try to continue with Google this time. Okay, great. So this time it did let me log in, which is awesome. And then let's see if I add, add people here. Let's add, let me go make sure I press the plus button. Next, add all suggestions, finish setup, launch the app. So I just sent, can you make the chores and family in the app real data from the database so I can really test it? So I think basically what happened is that it's using sample data instead of actually using real data from our database. Because I see in the database, we do have the data that I put in. So I'm just testing this again to see if this is going to work correctly. Let's finish the setup, go to launch flow. Okay. And it looks like, yeah, under here, it's still, okay. It's getting closer, but now it looks like it's pulling in all of the family members from every family into my account. And then same with the chores, unfortunately. So it's close, it's getting closer, but it's still not perfect. Okay, and then I'm also, looks like out of credits. So I'm gonna pause there with my building. I'm confident that if I had more credits and kept prompting, we would be able to get the code to resolve this and actually work. My overall impression is really good of Base44. I really like that it has the integrated database and user authentication. Authentication means users can sign in and out. Database means that like everything about the app that is stored about a user is all within Base44. I like that I don't have to worry about integrating with Supabase or another external database. That also means I don't have to pay for another service. So I like that everything is integrated. And I think that I would definitely recommend this to people who are maybe a little bit less technical. However, there is still a bit of a technical hurdle right now because, you know, you're going to run into things like we did in this video where something's not working correctly. You need to know how to ask the AI to make those changes. But that's kind of my overall view here. I really like how everything is integrated. I think it's definitely worth testing out and also worth some more experimentation. I probably will end up purchasing a plan and using it more and experimenting with more apps. And be sure to subscribe to our channel because we'll probably do another review of Base44 in the future, building it out more with more detailed prompts and seeing how far we can get.